So now we're coming up towards Portsmouth, so we're going to cross the shipping lane. We've got to make sure there's no traffic, so we're going to use the AIS for that.
So what is AIS, and how's it going to help us stay safe in the shipping lane? Since the year 2000, the population of the world has been able to access timing signals from the US military satellites. Triangulate your position using those satellites, and you know exactly where you are anywhere on the Earth. Feed that information into a suitable chart plotter, and you can see your position relative to other objects on the chart. Essentially, that GPS information is just a small text message, and these days we're exchanging text messages by the million. So if I could text other ships my position, they could plot my position on their chart plotters. Automate the texting process using some kind of computer and send the text messages using a couple of spare VHF channels from the ship's existing VHF systems and feed those text messages into your chart plotter. Refresh that information every few seconds and you can work out direction and speed of your vessel and all the other vessels. The chart plotter can even work out if there's a likelihood of collision and provide a warning. Combine your transmitter unit with your AIS receiver and your GPS receiver into one box and you get an AIS transponder. Now there are many different flavours of transponder unit. Aboard Confidence I use the Digital Yacht AIT 2000 and that comes with a nifty piece of software called Pro AIS, which amongst the other things that it does allows me to plug my laptop directly into the transponder and see the text messages coming in. Fascinating stuff, but probably time to get back to the boat and see how we're getting on crossing the shipping lane in Portsmouth. That's a shot of the laptop screen with a chart plotter on it. And as you can see, we're very close to crossing the main entrance channel into Portsmouth Harbour. Here we can expect to see heavy shipping coming in from the southeast into the harbour, as well as the continuous toing and froing of the car ferries from Portsmouth to Fishbourne on the Isle of Wight. The car ferries leave the harbour and then turn southwest at number 2 bar to cross the Swashway. If we declutter this screen a little bit, we can add on the fast catamaran service from Portsmouth's Harbour Station to Ryde Pierhead. Then there's the vessels coming in from the west, from Southampton, and of course the hovercraft service from Ryde to Southsea. Add to that military vessels on manoeuvre, dredgers and other port works vessels, pilot boats coming in and out, and numerous leisure vessels, and you really have to have your wits about you, especially in rough weather or in poor visibility. So we've got one of the car ferries, Victoria of Wight, turning round number 2 bar to cross the Swash on the southeast, and then on her way back from Fishbourne is St Clair, although she's a fair distance away. To the west we've got the Portsmouth Harbour trip boat, White Scene, and just slightly to the east of her, rounding Gilkicker, is Blade Runner 2. Both inbound for Portsmouth, but neither of them going to get in our way. So we're satisfied that there's no traffic coming, and it's safe to cross the shipping lane. That starboard hand mark ahead of us is the Castle, and once we've passed that, we're in safe water. Once we're past the mark, we can relax, put the kettle on, and have a look at this AIS software in more detail. First thing then, click the AIS toolbar and toggle the targets on. You can then use the inquire target function to interrogate any one of those little green triangles and get a screen with a lot more detail on it. You see, those text messages I was talking about don't just have the GPS information on. For a Class A vessel, which is any vessel that's commercial, you'll find the vessel's name, its unique Maritime Mobile Service Identity Number, MMSI, and a whole host of other information, including where it might be headed, what kind of vessel it is, its dimensions, and also, quite importantly, its status, whether it's underway or at anchor, restricted in its ability to manoeuvre, constrained by its draft, and all those other statuses that we're used to hearing about. I use EuroNav's SeaPro 3000 software as my primary electronic chart plotter. It's installed on a Windows 10 laptop, and it receives its AIS and its GPS data directly from the AIT 2000. Most electronic chart systems follow the same sort of processes, and whilst there's obviously some differences, the basics are shared across all the different options available. One very popular electronic chart system is OpenCPN, It's free to download and use, and I have a copy that I keep on the same laptop. So here's a comparison target inquiry. Of course, you don't need to be on a boat to look at AIS data. There are several good quality websites that allow the armchair sailor to track shipping movements all over the world. However, the delays in delivering this information mean it's completely unusable for live navigation. However, it's great for testing your own transponder before you go out on a voyage, and also for family and friends to keep a track of where you are when you're out sailing. So that's the end of part one. Part two is going to have a deep dive into some of the other features of AIS. So if you like what you see here, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and we'll see you on the next one.